God bless you. May God forever keep you. Just want to share a daily word with you today. There's a passage that says, be not weary in well doing, for in due season you should reap if you faint not. My brothers and sisters, what an encouraging word. What an encouraging word. Many of us labor hard. Sometimes the devil tries to make us think that our labor is useless, is worthless. But the word of God reminds us to encourage us and be not weary. Be not weary in well doing. In other words, keep on doing good. Keep on doing the right thing. Keep on faring well. Keep on doing well. Keep on sharing. Keep on doing those things that you know are right. Be not weary and well doing. He says, for in due season, in due season, in God's time, in God's own time, he said, you should reap if you don't faint, if you don't give up. A lot of times we do so much trying to do good, and sometimes we get nothing but seemingly slap in the face by much well doing. Makes it the devil trying to make us want to. So what's the use? Give up. Don't do it no more. Don't help no more. Don't try no more. Just forget about it. I want you to know, God got a time set. It says, be not weary in your well-doing, but in due season, in God's own time, you shall reap. If you don't give up, if you cannot give up, don't you dare think about giving up. That's a saying, a winner never quit, and a quitter never win. Don't you dare give up. That's the cheapest trick of the devil. The devil can't take nothing from you. He can't make you miss none of your rewards, but he can make you forfeit. That's the only way he can do it. He can make you forfeit if he can get you to surrender, to give up, to give in. That's the only way he can defeat you, because the Bible tells us, as long as we got Jesus, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. So therefore, we are automatic winners as long as we got Jesus within us. And the only way the devil can overtake us is that we give up, we surrender, we throw in the towel, we quit. That's why the Bible encourages us, be not weary. You see, you should reap if you faint not. Don't you dare think about giving up. I know it's wrong. I know you think you're down to the last, no way out. But don't you give up. Don't you dare think about giving up. If the devil can tell him he got to take it, he gonna have to take you out, because you're not gonna give up. You have to, in other words, if you get me, I'm going out fighting. I'm going out in faith. I'm going out believing. You've got to have the faith of the three Hebrew boys. Yes, God is able. But even if he don't deliver us, we're not going to bow to your iron God. That's the kind of faith you have to have in these times. You've got to have a no give in or no bow type of faith. No quitting type of faith. Believe in God to the very end. And even through the very end. My brother and sister, be not weary in your well doing. In due season. What I'm saying is, just keep on doing the right thing. Your day coming. Your day is coming. For to everything, there's given up, there's a season. There's a day. Payday is coming. Because the Lord said, if you don't faint, you should reap in due season. And don't get frustrated because your season hadn't come. Just hold on. Your day is coming. Because God has promised it in his word. Do not even think about giving up. Do not even think about giving in. Do not even think about turning around. because that's what the devil wants you to do. I want you to know that God wants you to hold on. He wants you to keep on doing the best you can with what you have. That's all my brothers and sisters, any of us can do is the best that we can with what we have. That's all God requires of anybody. You cannot do no more than your best. And don't get frustrated. Don't get discouraged because things may not be going like you think they ought to. This way, Jesus said, if any man come after me, he must take up his cross and follow me daily. We have daily crosses that we have to pass. So don't you be weary in your way of doing. You just keep on fighting. You keep on going. You keep on praying. You keep the faith. Eventually, God's word, he is faithful to his promise. Don't you dare think about giving up. Don't you dare think about it. The God in you is greater than anything that can ever come against you. I want to say that to encourage you is the word of the day. So whatever you were thinking about quitting, give it up on. You hold on. You trust God. You believe God. You know that all things work together for the good of them that love the Lord. And no matter how bad it may seem, God's will has got your back. Be not weary and well doing. Due season. Read. If. Don't give up. Hold on. Keep believing. Keep. God bless your heart. If you forever be free. Just wanted to share that word with somebody. Don't know who it's for. Might even be for you because the devil will try to get us all that way sometimes. He'll try to make us all want to give up because we run into so many difficulties in the things we endeavor to try to do. I want you to know, you hold fast. You keep doing what you're doing that's right in the name of the Lord. And I guarantee you, he says, be not weary and well doing for the due season. And thank God for the due season. Don't know when it is. Don't know how long or how far it is away. But I do know it's coming. There is a due season. The season that's due me. Hallelujah. Do me, and God is going to bring it to pass. In due season, you should reap if you faint not, if you don't give up. Till next time, Brother Leon Taylor is my prayer. The Lord plan all of our feet on higher grounds. Only way we're going to get to high ground. God bless God. Oh, Lord. Yes.